Hello friends, I'm the Travelers Nayak. I welcome all of you to this MOOC on Academic Counseling for ODL Learners. In this small video, I'm going to discuss how to design and develop the self-learning materials. Before we design the self-learning materials, we must remember a few principles. First, we must know who is the target group, who are the people who are going to be benefited from these materials. We must understand the interests of the learners, their levels of maturity, and their profiles. The contents that we design, the activities, and the procedures of study that we plan for the self-learning materials should be based upon the profile of the learners. We should encourage the learners to reflect upon their experience, to relate their real life to what they are learning in the self-instructional materials, and to learn new things from the materials that they are studying. The assessment procedure that we recommend for the self-learning materials should be self-assessment or should be self-evaluation. It should not be focusing merely upon the formal assessment of the learners. So, on the whole, we can say that the learners occupy a very important role in the self-instructional materials. Now, let us discuss what are the different components of a self-learning unit. First of all, we have the beginning of the unit, then we have the middle of the unit, then we have the ending of the unit. In the beginning of the unit, we have three components. The first one, it is the structure. The second one is the introduction. And the third one is the set of objectives. Under the structure, we have the topics and the subtopics, or sometimes the sub-subtopics. They are organized in a very sequential manner. Then we have the introduction. Introduction, as we know, it is the gateway for the learners to the unit. The learners get to know what is there in the unit through the introduction. It has three components: the thematic component, then the structural component, then the guidance component. The thematic component tells the learners what content or theme that they are going to cover after they study the unit. The structural component relates the present unit to the previous unit and helps the learners relate their previous learning to the things that they are going to learn in the present unit. And finally, the guidance component, it tells the learners what they are supposed to know or do before they study the unit. Now we have the objectives. As we know, the objectives help the learner know what they are expected to know at the end of studying the unit and how they are expected to behave after studying the unit and what kind of achievement that they are going to achieve after studying the unit. It has three components. The first one, it is the content. The second one, it is the behavior. And the third one, it is the level. Under content, as we know, it tells what the learners are going to learn, what kind of content the unit is going to cover. Then we have behavior. What kind of behavior that the learners are expected to exhibit, expected to show at the end of studying the unit. And the third part, that is the level. This part tells the learners what level or what standard they are supposed to achieve after studying the unit. Then we come to the middle part of the unit. Middle part of the unit, as we know, it is the most important part because it is the body of the unit. This contains, first of all, the topic, the subtopics, the sub-subtopics in a very sequential manner. Then the contents are organized in this body part of the unit in a very sequential, a very systematic manner. They are organized from the known to the unknown, from the familiar to the unfamiliar, so that the learners don't feel uncomfortable while studying the unit. There should be logical sequence between the topics which are being presented in the unit. The style that the writer, that the teacher adopts while writing the unit should be purely conversational, purely personal. The learners should feel as if a teacher is standing in front of them and explaining the things to them. Now let us see what kind of language that the teachers are supposed to use while writing a self-instructional, a self-learning unit. The language should be very, very simple. It should be comprehensible. There should not be any bombastic words. the sentences should be very simple, and as much as possible, the teachers should be avoiding complex sentences which will not help the learners comprehend the contents in a proper manner. And we should take care that we should put a pinch of humor during the writing of the self-instructional unit, because we know that the learners in the distance learning system, they are isolated and they are not getting any chance to interact with their peers. So a pinch of humor, a bit of humor will definitely keep them active and keep up their spirit so that they remain motivated. Now let us see what kind of activities that the learners are supposed to do during the study of the self-learning materials. What are the activities? They could be doing activities, what they are expected to do. Then there could be writing activities, what they are expected to write while reading the unit, after reading the unit. And the last part of activity, that is the thinking activities. What kind of activities that can force them, can prompt them to think. That means these activities should help them think properly, and they should be able to be active throughout reading the unit. Okay. Then there should be assessment questions. The questions should be, as we have already said, there should be self-assessment questions, and learners should be able to assess their progress, evaluate their progress from time to time. There should be illustrations, there should be examples, there should be tables to help the learners understand the contents in a very easy and comprehensible manner. And finally, we have the ending of the unit. The ending of the unit, as we know, mainly consists of the let's sum up, your summary part of the unit. This part of the unit recapitulates, your consolidates all the points which have been covered in the unit. Then we have the glossary also, which explains the difficult words or phrases which have been used in the unit. Then we have the answers to the self-check exercises, your self-assessment questions. We also have the suggested reading. Then we have the unit and exercises. These are additional exercises which are given to the learners to understand the unit in a better manner. Thank you very much. Happy learning. Thank you.